Hello and welcome to NRCC Exploring Doing Business in the Netherlands. I'm Teodora Tompea and we are addressing to the audience to the Romanian companies interested in expanding in the Netherlands today. Loredana van der Waart, partner, business lawyer at BBW Law. Hello, thank you so much for being here.
Hello, Teodora. Nice to meet you.
In introduction, please let's tell a few words for the audience about BBW Law. What's your experience and what does the company do?
Yes, we are a business law firm. I am a lawyer registered with the Bar Bucharest Bar Association, and I'm working for more than 25 years with a foreign investor in Romania, with mostly of them French, Dutch, Belgium, and Swiss. And in my experience with the foreign investor in Romania, I worked a lot with Dutch companies who came to invest in Romania, but also with Romanian companies who wanted to invest and or extend their business in Netherlands. Of course, to be clear, I am not a Dutch lawyer, so I'm not giving consultancy or assistance on Dutch law. I'm working and collaborating with fellows lawyers in Netherlands. So depending of the legal areas of each investment, I could recommend someone. But I have do of my business and family relation with Netherlands. I have a good understanding of the culture and of the legal system in Netherlands.
And how can could you facilitate Romanian investors' understanding of the legal disparities and aid in successful establishing in Netherlands?
I am specialized in international business law. I, in my experience, and I also follow some courses in international and European law. So I worked a lot on comparative law, and that's why I find out which are the differences between the Dutch law and the Romanian law to better understand what my Dutch clients are requesting when they are coming in Romania, and also to be able to advise the Romanian companies or Romanian investor who are going in the Netherlands, because it's very important when you go to invest in a country, even if it's Romania or Netherlands, to understand the similarities but also the differences between the two legal systems. Business means also a lot of obligation and the rights which are provided in the system, in the law system.
Can you outline the primary sources of business law in the Netherlands and how do they differ from Romanian law?
At first glance, actually seems very different, but
they're not so different.
They're not so different because both legal system are they have the same source, which is the French Napoleon Civil Code. So the Romanian Civil Code and the Dutch Civil Code is based on the French Napoleon Civil Code. Of course, during time, the Dutch system law is more appropriate and influenced by the German law, and the Romanian one remains more closed by the French one. But in having the same principle, you can find the same obligation, mainly the same obligation and rights, especially in the civil, in the civil law. Of course, there are some differences and important differences in the procedures. In the same time, after 2007, when Romania joined the European Union, we have a lot of regulation which applies identically in the Netherlands and exactly and in Romania. We have the jurisdiction of the European Court, which is mandatory for Netherlands and for Romania. We have also some directives, which the directives are legislation that are not applied directly but has to be transposed by the yes, by the Parliament. But nevertheless, the main principle remain the same. So, quite a lot of similarities between the two systems.
Can you provide us some hints on incorporating a BV in the Netherlands, comparing with incorporating a Romanian limited liability company?
Yes. The BV is actually the limited liability company in the Netherlands. It's the one which is more used by all the investors in the Netherlands. In Romania, the limited liability company, there is no obligation to have a minimum social capital. So you have to pay 0.01 euros to start the registration. There is also the registration with the Dutch Chamber of Commerce, which is in Romania, it's Registrul Comerțului. The main difference is, I will say, is the fact that in the Netherlands to incorporate a company you have to go to a notary. So the article of incorporation, it's drafted by the notary and it's signed before a notary. Starting with 24, they introduce a digital possibility to incorporate a company, but of course this is based on a digital notary procedure. So it is important that the notary, the Dutch notary, accept to introduce you only digital, which here I have some mark questions. Yes. If a Dutch notary will accept for foreign investor, especially in Romania, because still European, East European countries are not so well see in the Netherlands. Sure. So there could be some notary that will refuse to do this digital registration of a company. On the other hand, in the BV, you could have one director, you could have one sole shareholder, like in Romania. Of course, you need to have headquarters, you have to register also from the tax point of view, but this is mainly made by a notary also.
What are the key steps and formalities involved, beside, as you said before, involved in registering a branch of a Romanian company in the Netherlands? And here I want you to provide us some hints about this step.
First of all, the registration of a branch, it's starting in Romania, because you have to not in Netherlands. You have to decide at Romanian level, corporate level, to register outside of Romania a branch. After that, you go to the trade register, to the Dutch Chamber of Commerce, to register the branch. The branch, comparing with the BV, doesn't have a legal personality. So the Romanian company remain liable for all the obligation that the branch will take over. And from the tax point of view, a branch represent a permanent establishment. So all the incomes that will be produced by the branch should be paid in the Netherlands. So you have to have also a registration with the tax authorities in Netherlands, to have an accountant in Netherlands. It's also very important to have an accountant also in Romania, because there is the double taxation between the two countries that should be taken care of in the moment you decide to register the branch in the Netherlands.
And when you sign a contract with the Dutch companies, what clauses should the Romanian pay attention for?
I think, of course, you should take care of all the clauses, yes. But it's very important from my point of view, when you decide to sign with a Dutch company or with other foreign company, even European, you have to be very careful to see which is the applicable law. Because depending of the applicable law, there could be consequences and there could be effects. So there is at European level, there is a regulation, it's named Rome 1, which provides, if the party does not establish exactly which is the applicable law, what law should apply to your contract. But it's much better to have a provision, a clause in your contract saying which law should apply to your contract. And other clause, which is also very important, it's the jurisdiction clause, because it's important to know if you'll have a litigation, a dispute, where you should go to settle that dispute, in front of which court, in front of Dutch court or in front of Romanian courts. Because if the contract will be submitted to the Dutch law, it's better to have a jurisdiction in Netherlands. If it's submitted to the Romanian law, it's better to have the jurisdiction in Romania.
And you have to be flexible.
Yes, but there are situations when actually it's applied the Dutch law with a jurisdiction in Romania, and this is crazy for lawyers.
It's very complicated.
And for the judges, because they have to have some information what the Dutch law provides and so on. So I think
the lawyers can talk between them,
but also in the end, I think it's very important, the one who judge your case, to know, to have a good knowledge of the applicable law of your contract. So that's why I all the time say, okay, there are a lot of clauses, very important, but these two are the main, because the contract all the time is needed when there is a dispute. If the parties are settled, they have a good relation, you don't need so much the contract, you know, but when there is a dispute, you need a contract.
Of course.
So that's why you have to prepare it for that.
Let's talk a little bit about real estate, because how can one obtain details about property ownership rights?
As in Romania, there is also in Netherlands. In Romania, we have carte funciară, land book. In Netherlands, it's cadastre. NL, and you can find there if someone is owner of that building, of that land. So it's very important to check before you are thinking to buy or to rent, especially to rent, because when you buy something, like in Romania, you have to go to the notary.
Yes.
So all the sale, purchase, contract are done by in front of the notary, and normally they are the person who are checking all the ownerships and who tells you what documents you have to provide, which are your obligation, rights, so on. But when you rent someone, it's very important to be sure that the one who saying that it's the owner, it's as the owner. So you can check. What is important to know is that in Netherlands you have almost all the information you need online.
So it's not like here.
Yeah, and most of them are also in English. So it's very easy to find out all the information you need. Of course, it's better to go when you have an important contract or you want to invest and to do
to
your business,
yes,
to go also to some consultant lawyers to understand better what do you want and which are the effects for your business.
It's more safe to go to an agency, a real estate agency, or?
Yes, you can go to
or by yourself.
This is the first step. It's better to go to to a real estate agency, because even in Netherlands there is a site, a website. It's funda.nl, where you can find almost all the real estate on sale or in rent, but all the time they are recommend you to go through your agency. In Netherlands, there are not so many agencies which are agent of the seller or the buyer, so in general they are specialized, so it's or for the buyer or for the seller, so also for the lessee or for the owners.
And what are the formal requirements for the signing of the property acquisition?
It's the contract, and which is drafted by the notary. Of course, if there is a new building, it's the developer, like in Romania. But the difference is that in Netherlands there are so many regulations to protect the consumers. Also, from in the real estate area in Romania, it's there is no regulation. From my point of view, actually, the consumer are not at all protected from when we are talking about new buildings, new construction. In Netherlands, it's very different. They are obliged to have an insurance, to give you 2 months in order to find.
So if you rent or you buy something, you are safe.
Yeah, especially when you buy. And for rent also, there are so many provision very favorable to the leases. So it's you are much more protected, but it's in the law, let's say like this, for the consumer. When we are talking about business, it's less protected. Because when it's a business like in Romania, when we have business to business, you have less protection than when you are a consumer with business.
So as a conclusion, we can say that it's safe and it's very good to invest over there.
Yes. I think it's very safe.
And the law is favorable.
Yes, Netherlands actually is considered for all the investors outside of Europe one of the most secure country. And after the Brexit, actually they started because a lot of business from United Kingdom moved in Netherlands, in Amsterdam, and they develop also the court in Netherlands, especially in Amsterdam. They develop also disputes in English. Even the contracts, even they are on Dutch law, you can go in front of the Dutch court, but to plead in English. So they are prepared and they transform their business in order to be more open to the foreign investor. Yeah, flexible, exactly.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Teodora.